When I was 17, I was homeless. And so I spent many nights sleeping in my car in the Best Buy parking lot up top level in San Rafael. Because I didn't have parents, my mom had problems with drugs, my dad, I met him when I was 17, in jail through a television screen. I had to work, I was a hustler, so I was doing any kind of job that I could do. I was working 80 hours a week, and I knew that the only thing that I had for me was to be the first in my family to go to college, and I got accepted to UC Berkeley on a full scholarship. Zara, and she had this organization out here in Marin, Ambassadors of Hope and Opportunity, which she was telling you about. And through this organization, she was able to connect me with the community, to internships, to jobs, to things that were going to be able to help me get on that path and to really actually achieve being at the school, right? And so about 5 years ago, there were some youth that had been helped by the program, and they wanted to have a way to give back to ambassadors. And they say, hey, look, there's not enough community in the program. We actually want to meet on a weekly basis to come up with projects that we'll be able to get youth to work on and then give them back to the community. And so this I actually thought of and been thought about 5 years ago, but we didn't have the resources in order to make it a reality until recently. And so about a year ago, that's when we started doing all the planning. That's when you probably had somebody come up into your art classes and tell you about the mural, and a lot of you had raised your hands about creating the birds and the leaves for this mural. So we worked on this throughout the entire summer. It was a really labor-intensive project. It took over 30 high schools with 1,200 youth in order to make this possible. I worked on it about 12 hours per week. As you can see here, this is the Autumn of Abundance here. This is my very first painting that I ever did, and I'm really glad that some people can recognize that it's Tupac. I'm a rapper, he's a rapper. I want to go ahead and introduce him because he's going to talk about his participation in the project as well and some of the things that he had contributed into painting and drawing. So,
good morning, San Marin. I am, of course, Sam Ladig, and I'm actually an alumni of San Marin High School. So, of course, I graduated class of 2011. I started to go to college, but unfortunately, due to some emotional and family troubles, I eventually wound up homeless. So I sort of came back up to Marin County. I was couch surfing for about 2 months, and then basically that was it. I was sort of on my own and just sort of winging it, not really knowing what to do. Something came up is I found out about an art project that was going on over the summer. I started going to it, and then I just got really involved in it because, you know, I was expressing talent, and I could just put myself out there, get my thoughts out. There were lots of people there who really understand the issue, who care about the issue, who sort of are involved because of, like, Kayla, she was homeless, so she knows what this is all about.
There's the number 350. But it was actually 350 parts per million of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is what's actually the limit for being able to sustain human and all forms of life on Earth. And right now we're at 392 and growing.
The hungry, hungry caterpillar, which represents what mankind is sort of built up to as the consumer, sort of taking all the leaves, chowing down, not really thinking about where it's going to go or what its effect is on what it's eating. But currently, we're in the chrysalis stage, where we've basically done all the eating, but we're thinking about it. You know, we're getting to another stage in our lives where we think about what we're doing. We're contemplating the consequences. So we can eventually become the butterfly. The butterfly, which is part man, with all of the animals, because it's not only us that's part of the earth, it's everything that's part of the earth. Animals, plants, everything that's alive. So we want to be one with everything. We want to understand. You know, we want to be at peace.
So it takes place in World War I. And, you know, World War I, huge war, lots of casualties, lots of death, lots of destruction, right? So at the end of one battle one night, the soldiers saw that everything around them was destroyed, and they crawled on their bellies for miles and miles until they came to one tree. And it was the only tree that had survived in the landscape. And what they saw was something that had never been seen before, that all of the life forms from the surrounding areas and all of the birds that would normally never be found together in nature were all flocked and perched on this one tree, singing a song that had never been heard before because they had never come together before and they wouldn't have otherwise. And so in the midst of all this madness, all this chaos, and all of this negativity, this destruction, there was a symbol of hope, which is kind of what you mentioned. It's a symbol of peace that had arisen. And so this is very much metaphorical for what we've been able to accomplish out here with you guys and the other 29 high schools that participated. Because you, without knowing it, were actually working with youth that you probably would have never met or worked with before, other than without this project. A lot of you had come up here before we had started speaking and looking like, oh, this is my leaf, I found it. And you know, you're in the midst of all of these other spirits, all of these other bodies who had basically manifested the vision of the world that they wanted to live in on here. And that's what this wholeness is about and this creation. And so that's why we decided to do the singing tree, to replicate that and to always honor that story.
Sometimes in our lives, we all